trans boy, but I'm really feminine. And I've tried to come out to my mom, and she always tells me that I'm too girly to be a boy, and we end up fighting. And I don't know how to talk to her without being a total brat. So if you guys could help me out, that would be really awesome. Thank you.
I like you.
That's interesting.
And so interesting. My brain started off being like, this is interesting. And then when he was like, I don't know how to talk to her without being a total brat. Yeah. I was like, you're the cutest. Because it's an awesome thing that I think a lot of people who still live with their parents have, where you're aware of the fact that you're acting like a brat and you can't help yourself, but you're just like, blah, you know? Anyway.
I think I'm really glad you called, because I think that while we don't get millions and what?
I'm sorry.
What did you
do? I didn't do anything. It's just that you were like Dr. Phil for a second.
I'm really glad that you called.
Me too.
Okay. Because while we don't get millions of questions from folks in the trans community, we do get a handful, and I feel like they're always trans boys who are like, I am a boy, and I want everyone to accept that. Mm-hmm. I mean, you're a trans boy, and you're a little bit more feminine, and so people are like, no, you can't be a boy, because you're feminine. But when there's just a cisgender boy who is gay, nobody says, no, you can't be a boy because you're gay.
Right.
So.
Right. Or if there's a cisgender male who identifies as straight, but also has attributes about himself that might be categorized as feminine, we don't say, well, you must not be a boy then, because you identifying as a boy, or as anything for that matter, is not dependent on the way that you carry yourself, the way that you speak, the way that you dress.
It's actually completely separate.
It is. Those factors are all really independent of each other, and like, you know, we're all taught and trained to think of these things in molds and think, you know, if you're a girl, then typically you would wear dresses. And if you're a boy, then typically you would like to wear pants and play sports. Mm-hmm. But any sampling of the human population would prove really easily that that's not at all the case, that we are much more complex and can be fit into two categories.
I feel like, as far as talking to your mother, the best way to go about it would be to be very calm about it and say, this is confusing for me as well as you, and I would love to talk about it, but I really don't want to fight about it because I don't feel like it's fair. I don't feel like it's fair for me to tell you who you are, and I don't think it's fair that you're trying to tell me who I am. And I told you because I want to be able to talk to you and I want to be open with you. Can we just have a conversation?
Yeah, and your mission should be to not get angry with her misunderstanding some of what you're saying, because try to put yourself in her position. She's known you for however many years you've been on this planet. She's known you as her daughter. And so regardless of the circumstances and regardless of the way that you are perceived in the world, she would be struggling with this. It's a very big change. It's a very big thing to adjust to. So give her that space. And then I think bring up the point that we just said. Like, say, listen, I know this is hard. I know that it's hard to understand. But if I were born your son and you thought that I acted feminine, would you think that I wasn't your son anymore? You know, and maybe that will help her to start to understand that these things are not always interconnected the way that we think that they are. Be patient, be calm, give it time, and
always be willing to talk about it.
And we're glad you called. Okay.
Hey, Christian and Danielle. I love your show, by the way. I am calling because I am a total nerd and I have, quote unquote, no game. So I'm wondering, how does a person with no game get game or get girls? Bye.
You want to know somebody with no game? All right. So what's she supposed to do?
I don't know. You're asking the wrong girls.
Well, sorry.
Click. We can tell her what we think is gamey.
Gamey. First of all, use the word gamey. Really helps bring romance into the situation. Okay, what do you think would work for game?
I don't don't know, because generally when people flirt, I think it's stupid and weird.
Right?
If someone was like, hey, so, how are you? I'd be like, get away from me.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. If you're saying you have no game because when a girl who you have a huge crush on asks you if you like the latest episode of The Voice and you forget your name and her name and everything else around you, that's normal.
Yeah, that's just having a crush. When you think of someone who has game, you think of someone, like, at a gay club dancing on people.
Actually, what I think of when I think of somebody having game is somebody who...
plays basketball.
No. No. But he got game. What I think of when somebody has game is when somebody doesn't outwardly show a ton of emotion. Because for me, that's how you get me.
For me, someone just being kind and honest.
I think the solution is to not try to flirt with people. Your objective, instead of, I would like to flirt with this person, should be, I would love to start up a conversation with this person. Like, that should be the end goal. Even if you wind up, like, saying ridiculous things and you, like, back out the door and you're like, anyway, bye! If the girl likes you, she's gonna like you even more because you were uncomfortable.
Yeah. So don't focus on having game, because, let's be real, anyone who's like, hey, what's up, I have so much game, is an idiot.
Yeah. Hey girl, how's it going?
Do it to the computer, don't look at me.
Hey girl, how's it going? Right?
Yeah.
It's ridiculous.
Yeah, it's pretty
all the boners in the world go like this. I'll be a boner meter in the back.
Okay, boner meter. Okay, boner meter. I'm gonna do three different things. Okay?
I start with a boner, just
yes.
So you know.
Either way, you always have a boner. You're walking boner. Around boner town all the time, okay? You act naturally, okay? Don't get your boner, not you. Be serious, okay? Hey, how's it going? Okay, so you still have a boner, we're great, okay?
Yeah, we're good.
Time two. Hey, so, how you doing? I couldn't see the boner flattening in my eye.
Okay.
Hey, did you, get that shirt from, I'm sorry, never mind. I'm gonna go.
Remember when you looked my boner in the eye and said, act natural? we're done, right?
That's what she said.
I can't, you're out of the frame again.
I am?
Yeah.
Oh, shit. God damn it. Okay. Maybe lay down? Yeah, that's probably better, right?
Yeah, I guess. Let me see. Wait, why?
Because of the members of the band.
Oh, I see. Ow. Okay, where?
Can you see?
Pull your blanket up.
Okay. Nothing's gotta give now.
But I can see your whole elbow.
Nothing's gotta give now.
Oh, yeah, I guess my paper will cover your elbow.
Yeah. Right?
How are you gonna start the song?
I'm gonna push play.
We're gonna lean back. I'm gonna push play.
Okay.
And then I'm gonna drink.
It's very possible that I'm gonna pee in the
bed. Wait. My blanket.
Oh my god.